Respected Chairperson and this learned audience, I must thank the organizers for giving me the chance in front of this August gathering, and I must thank you all for being here in this evening, and the hall is almost full. In this topic, we will cover the highlights of these AACE obesity guidelines, the unique features of obesity in India, and the relevance of AACE guidelines in Indian context. So all these pillars of these recommendations of these AACE obesity guidelines is the recommendations from this consensus conference on obesity occurred in March last year in Washington, and all these comprehensive guidelines published in last 1 or 2 years. The major change which has shifted from all previous guidelines is that they have questioned whether this obesity term should be replaced with a meaningful, scientifically updated, newer name, just to have some idea how to approach this problem. There is stigmatization. The problem of weight is not the issue. It is a concept of weight-driven disease that is to be tackled. It is a complication-centric approach to diagnosis and management, and prevention and treatment of this disease and these complications are more important. So new definition is required, which is actionable by all and medically meaningful, and they have suggested one name, adiposity-based chronic disease. So it is not the muscle mass or bone mass, it is the adiposity which is important. So diagnostic definition, which is important, is that the obesity has been accepted as a chronic disease by many bodies, but concerted action is required to decrease this rapid rise in prevalence. But despite recognition as a chronic disease, diagnosis of obesity has not changed, and definition and diagnosis of obesity is a major obstacle to concerted action and effective public health initiative. So old diagnosis relies more on this BMI, and there is uncertainty of how increased BMI affects individual health. So to remove this problem of diagnostic uncertainty at first, to develop a concerted and comprehensive action among the healthcare professionals and regulators to combat obesity, and to achieve a more medically meaningful and actionable definition for better interventions for prevention and treatment of obesity, and to include anthropometric criteria along with the degree of adverse effects of weight gain on the health of the individuals. So it has two components. Number one is anthropometry, and number two, presence and severity of the obesity-related complications. So complications are cardiometabolic as well as biomechanical. So complete diagnosis does not simply depend upon BMI, but also the impact of weight gain on health. It has four steps. So four-step approach is number one, screening. Next is diagnosis. Next is staging for selection of prevention of treatment and treatment strategies. So finally, it treats the complications as the end point of weight loss therapy and not BMI per se. So those who have BMI more than 25, that may have some ethnic adjustment. They have, and for those ethnically adjusted criteria, few ethnically group like South Asians may have this waist circumference as a criteria as well. So presence and severity of the obesity-related complication evaluation is very important, and staging to stage 0, 1, and 2 is depending on the level and severity of complications. So in the step 1, say screening with BMI and waist circumference. In step 2, physical examination, review of system and clinical laboratory. In step 3, severity of complications using complication-specific criteria. And in stage 4, selection of the treatment, intervention, or prevention criteria. So this is the look of this flowchart of these all four stages. To have a detailed view, the screening for all with BMI, if it is more than 25, it is a one component of obesity diagnosis, and BMI more than 25, it is overweight, and BMI more than 30, it is obesity. This is the international criteria, not the Indian one. And clinical component is the number two to complete the diagnosis, and certain ethnic groups like South Asians may have the 23 to 25 criteria depending on the increased waist circumference, this ethnicity specific criteria. In edematous, highly muscular, elderly persons with sarcopenic obesity, this DEXA can be used to identify the fat mass, and the anthropometric criteria is necessary but not sufficient for a complete diagnosis. So clinical component of diagnosis with obesity-related complications is the step 2, So pathophysiologic component as reflected in the complications as a marker of the disease severity is required in addition. So individuals who meet the anthropometric criteria for overweight or obesity must undergo evaluation for the presence or absence of obesity related complications, clinical criteria to complete the diagnosis of obesity. So very important is the history, physical examination, review of system, blood pressure, waist circumference, fasting glucose, lipid profile, creatinine, liver enzymes, in addition to the eating pattern, meal preferences, and physical activity level. So checklist of obesity related complications is there. This is a big checklist, and this basis of these is cardiometabolic and the biomechanical complications of obesity. So to have a better view of these metabolic syndrome, pre-diabetes, diabetes, hypertension, dyslipidemia, NAFLD, PCOS, all are there as has been discussed earlier also, and they have this initial evaluation, and for the confirmation of these, for better staging, there are lots of specific criteria. In the stage three, we stage this disease in overweight, stage one obesity, stage zero, and stage two, depending on the, severity of the complications. So this overweight is those who do not have any obesity related complication, and BMI is just more than 25 and less than 30. In stage zero, it is more than 30, and those do not have any complication. In stage one, they have mild to moderate complications only, but the BMI is less than 25, and stage two, they have severe level of complications. See, obesity stage 1 and stage 2, there is no distinction is made for overweight and obesity based on BMI alone, as excess weight has adversely affected the health. Patients have complications and will benefit from the weight loss therapy. So this is the staging of obesity related complications. So this is a congested slide. This is a part of it. Every criteria has stage 0 and stage 1 and stage 2 complication specific detail of these category. So after all these specifications, we finally stage the patient into overweight, obesity, on these obesity stage 1 and 2. And you can see that more than 25 BMI may be overweight, may be obesity stage 1 and obesity stage 2. So it is a complication-centric approach to the diagnosis. In the stage 4, we select this treatment and the intervention criteria according this management algorithm after diagnosis and complication staging are complete. So therapy should be individualized, and overweight and obesity stage 0, there is secondary level of care and prevention with lifestyle modification, health promoting meal pattern, behavior modification, and increased physical activity. In obesity stage 1, there is tertiary level of care with moderate. Only 3 to 10% weight loss is targeted with treating both weight and the weight related complications. In stage 2, there is tertiary level of care with more degree of weight loss, more than 10%, with intensive lifestyle and behavior therapy, with weight loss medication and bariatric surgery in order to effectively treat complications and not BMI per se. So obesity stage 0, 1 and 2 is a lifelong disease and will need ongoing follow-up and dynamic reassessment time to time for both anthropometric and clinical components of the diagnosis. So this is the flowchart of these intervention options of diagnosis and management of this. So as this is a congested slide, this is the better view. So primary care and the secondary care and the tertiary care has been planned. So secondary level of care has been suggested for this overweight and the obesity group, and this tertiary level of care in the obesity stage 1 and stage 2, those who have developed complications. So this BMI more than 25 may get the primary level of care, secondary level of care, as well as the tertiary level of care. So complication centric approach to prevention and treatment. If you see in detail that the secondary level, it is the overweight as well as the obesity group. So the question has been there, what is the use of keeping this overweight category? Is it redundant? Is it unnecessary? So the rationale of discrimination between overweight and obesity is not there. So obesity patients, the overweight patients, those who have been referred to without having any complications, they are actually staged in stage 1 and stage 2, and those who have complications. So overweight patients with any complication deserve same weight loss therapy as obese patients with the same complications. So why these patients with BMI more than 25 without complications should not be designated as obesity grade 0, stage 0? Should this differentiation be retained as prevalence of obesity related complications increase as BMI increases? So concept of pre-obesity has been there. So this is a question which has been raised. Is there any advantage to adapting this diagnosis of pre-obesity like pre-diabetes, pre-hypertension for overweight or obese patients without complications? Diagnosis in elderly patients has been discussed and placed as a question. So what should be the treatment and the diagnostic paradigm for more than 70 years persons who are sarcopenic? So role of waist circumference, should it be an essential anthropometric criteria for all or for subgroups like South Asians? And role of the patients with cardiometabolic risk, pre-diabetes or CVD? You can see in the South Asians, this more than 90 centimeter for males and more than 80 centimeter be very much important, because we are sarcopenic and we have less BMI while we develop this diabetes, I mean this is obesity group. So in certain ethnic groups like South Asians, when BMI is 23 to 25, it can be diagnosed as obese on the basis of increased waist circumference. So importance of AHCE guideline is that problem of obesity is cardiometabolic and mechanical complications. Screening of complications is the core of obesity management, and preferring obesity stage over obesity class for treatment in scientific, and especially for these cardiometabolic complications, and ethnicity has been taken into account for anthropometric measurements. So what is the relevance of AHCE guideline in Indian context? So relevance of the diagnostic approach, what is the completeness of this definition, screening of complications and staging of treatment choice, is it important? What is the challenge there in India? Strong need of quantifying and localizing the fat mass, particularly in Indian perspective, and maximum utilization of clinic-based measurements and clinic-based data in India is very much important. So detailed history, it is very much important in Indian context. Different BMI cut points according to ethnicity and screening for complications is very much important in Indian perspective. So changing dietary habits and dietary behavior is very important with this changing time. Physical activity level is gradually coming down in our country also. Stress level and maternal nutrition status from the history analysis is very important. Because in India, both overnutrition and undernutrition coexist, and mother's nutritional status affects obesity and risk in future generation is also there. Because obesity may transmit across the generation, those nutritionally deprived mother give birth to low birth weight infants, and they develop thrifty phenotype and increased obesity chance, with more chances of cardiometabolic risk is there. Obese mother and GDM mother, they deliver these hyperinsulinemic obese offspring with future risk of obesity, PCOS and diabetes mellitus. So different BMI cut points and role of waist circumference according to ethnicity is very much important, because we all know that Indians have more adiposity and less muscle mass compared to the European counterparts. So in India, the diagnostic criteria is 23 to 25 is overweight and more than 25 is obese, and this waist circumference has been taken into account. And this low subcutaneous adipose tissue, it is the marker of this Indian obesity, and low visceral adipose tissue is there, and more ectopic fat in the liver, muscles, pancreas, heart and vessels. As the subcutaneous tissue is low in India, so they develop more ectopic fat and the visceral fat, more abdominal obesity, more cardiometabolic complications in lower BMI, NAFLD in absence of overweight and obesity. So those patients who have these in the overweight category may not have increased waist circumference, but they may have all these ectopic fat and related cardiometabolic discrepancies. You see, this is a lipodystrophy patient, and these patients have all these features of diabetes, dyslipidemia, fatty liver, because this patient does not have adequate storage space in the subcutaneous area. So any fat which is stored is in the viscerals. So in India, it is much more important, because all these ectopic fat which is stored in the liver, in the muscles, in the pancreas, they give all these complications, and they develop all these cardiometabolic complications, including diabetes, at very low BMI state. So they develop more hypertension, more cardiovascular diseases, and more atherosclerotic diseases, because these ectopic fat in the kidney, the sinuses, and these tubules give more chances of hypertension, and these atherosclerotic diseases happen more when this ectopic fat is accumulated in the heart and the vessels. So strong need for quantifying and localizing fat mass is much more important in Indian context, because in British Journal of Nutrition recently, it has published that Asians have higher fat percentage, greater central fat distribution, and lower lean mass compared to BMI matched other ethnic groups. With increasing age, tendency to central distribution increases more in Asians, and percentage of total fat as abdominal fat was higher in Asians compared to the Europeans. And you can see this, these Asians have higher abdominal fat compared to the Europeans as percentage of the total body fat by decade of age in more in these Asians. There is a poor correlation between BMI and the percentage of body fat in Asians. You can see this correlation is less in this Asian group. So for a selective, body fat percentage, one European, say for this 20.6% body fat, so one European may have a BMI of 25, while one Indian will have only 19.5. And similarly, all these categories may have lower BMI for the similar level of percent body fat. So limitations of available data is that all these data have been selected from the Indians settled in Western countries, may not reflect the data of Indians settled in India. So screening for complications and staging for treatment choice, which is much more important here, to develop our own data. So there are challenges, there are numerous tests is required to identify the long checklist of complications, and India is a resource poor country. Healthcare in India is mostly self-financed. So possibility of exhaustion of financial resources before disease development and the disease treating is done. So what is the solution? Focus on the primary prevention, create awareness and facilities among all who are concerned, and comprehensive health insurance policies by government for early disease detection and treatment, and more importantly, early disease risk detection and prevention. So India is a hugely heterogeneous country. It is a mini continent in terms of size and a continent in terms of population. So waves of migrations taken place since the 4th century BC. There are, according to the Indian government data, there are Indo-Aryans, Dravidians, Mongoloids, and actual ethnic composition are much more complex than this. There are Negroids, Proto-Australoids, Dravidians, Mongoloids, Nordics, etc. And there are several other ethnic groups. So countrywide, region-based data is required for finding correlation between anthropometry, body composition, and obesity-associated cardiometabolic complications. It is a Herculean task for giant achievement of detailed research, and countrywide extensive collaboration is required under the auspices of doctors, other healthcare providers, statisticians, anthropologists, policymakers, social scientists, and corporates. So what should we aim to find? Correlation between different BMI groups and body fat mass and the percent body fat in our population. So visceral fat mass as percentage of total body fat mass in different BMI groups. Association of visceral fat mass, body fat, and BMI combination with obesity-related combinations. To establish a formula for prediction of obesity-related complication in our population from a combination of clinic-based measures like BMI, waist circumference, neck circumference, waist size ratio, sagittal abdominal diameter, blood pressure, etc. So to generate more Indian data, it is much more important the research, the streamlining our resources, identifying individuals who may need aggressive screening, identify novel risk and disease markers in India, identifying target values for treatment in our population, and justifying the cost effectiveness of obesity treatment in India, and to refine our approach to obesity in future. So ASCE obesity guideline may be the model for formulating our own guideline, with some modifications and improvements based on the data generated from our own population in India. And in coming time, all these refinements come in terms of the diagnosis, understanding, and planning therapy in